मॉर्निंग। आई एम कंटिन्यूइंग दिस एमलगमेशन क्लास टुडे। ओके, यस्टरडे अप टू नेट पेमेंट्स मेथड आई टोल्ड यू, नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू द कंटिन्यूएशन फॉर दैट नेट पेमेंट्स मेथड। ओके, एंड what are the accounting treatments that we come across in transfer company as well as in transferee company. These things I'm going to discuss today in this video class. After considering this net payments method, we'll have one more method that is nothing but shares exchange method. What is this shares exchange method? In this shares exchange method, the transferee company will pay its shares to the transferor company on amalgamation basis. Okay, the transferee company will pay the share, it will pay its own shares to the transferor company. Don't be of that opinion that the transferor company won't have any shares. Okay, whatever it may be, the number of shares that the transferor company is having, the same number of shares the transferee company, it will give from its own, okay, own number of shares. That thing we'll call that thing as shares exchange method. Okay, like this, there are four methods for calculation of purchase consideration, and you can follow any method. Okay, you can follow any method except lump sum method. You can follow net assets method, net assets method, net payments method, or shares exchange method. And people generally, they'll give much importance for net assets method and net payments method. Okay, in rare circumstances only they'll go for this shares exchange method. So like this, you'll have four methods for calculation of purchase price or purchase consideration. Now after this, we have to take into account the accounting treatment in the transfer company as well as accounting treatment in transferee company, because these accounting treatments or the journal entries that we come across, they are very, very important. Whether you go for absorption or whether you go for external reconstruction. Okay, so whatever it may be, the method and the procedure and the accounting treatment, it is one and the same when we go for this amalgamation, absorption, etc. Okay, now first of all, we are going for transfer company, and after transfer company we will go for transferee company. Now when you go for accounting treatment, mind it that you have to pass journal entries, compulsory, and unless otherwise they won't ask journal entries, there is no need for you to prepare this journal entries. Sometimes in some problems you will be asked to calculate, prepare necessary ledger accounts. So when you come across like that, you have to prepare ledger accounts without passing journal entries. But okay, when you are asked to prepare the journal entries, compulsory you have to prepare the journal entries. Okay, in transfer company, first entry is when all the assets are realized, when all the assets are transferred to realization account. Because one thing you have to keep in mind is the transfer company, it is closing its books. So when it is closing its books, means we have to prepare a separate account, and that account's name is realization account. And all the assets you have to transfer to realization account. Similarly, all the liabilities also you have to transfer to realization account. So first entry is realization account that are to various assets account individually. Okay, individually you have to transfer all the assets to the realization account. And this after passing the adjustment entry, you have to keep some points in your mind. So what are the assets? What are the points that we have to keep in our mind? The points are, first one is, you have to transfer the assets at their book values only. Okay, you should not go for, revalued figures. Only revalued figures will appear only in transferee company. But when you are passing to realization account, you have to take into account only the book values of the assets only. Next, if cash and bank balances are not taken over, you should not transfer the cash and bank balances. When the purchasing company, when it is not taking over the cash in hand and cash in bank, okay, you have to leave that and you should not transfer that to realization account. But when the purchasing company, when it says that we are taking into account the whole business, then you have to pass the cash in hand and cash in bank to realization account. Next, third one is, sundry debtors are to be transferred at their gross values. Okay, whatever it may be, the provisions, whatever it may be, the bad debts provision or doubtful debts provision or discount on debtors provision, whatever it may be, the provisions, you have to show them separately along with liabilities. But whatever it may be, the sundry debtors amount, you have to transfer at their original figures. Okay. Next, fictitious assets. Whatever it may be, the fictitious assets like preliminary expenses, okay, profit and loss, debit balance, all these things, you should not transfer to realization account. They must be transferred to shareholders account only. Next, intangible assets. Okay, intangible assets, unless otherwise stated, you should transfer that to the realization account. You should transfer that to the realization account. Next, the second entry. When we are going for the first entry, I told you some points, and these points you must be very careful and you have to keep them in your mind. And the second entry is, for transferring the liabilities in the sense outside liabilities, okay, not the shareholders' liabilities, please. Outside liabilities, whatever it may be, you have to transfer to realization account along with the provisions on debtors. So every liability account debtor, provision for bad and doubtful debts account debtor to realization account. Here also you have to note some points. Only those liabilities which are taken over by the purchasing company should be transferred to realization at their book values. Whatever it may be, the liabilities that the transferee company, whatever it is taking, that liabilities only are transferred to realization account at their book values. Next, if any fund seems to be like a liability, like workman's compensation fund, provident fund, all these things, okay, they must be transferred to realization account. Okay, they must be transferred to realization account. Next, accumulated profits and reserves, whatever it may be, should not transfer to realization account. They must be transferred to shareholders account. This is the points that you have to note down. Next, for purchase of consideration due, this is a due entry. Okay, so transferee company account debtor to realization account. This is a due entry for purchase consideration. And for receiving purchase consideration, okay, you have to receive. You didn't receive that, you have to receive. So in that case, what is the entry that we have to pass? Shares in transferee company account debtor to bank, shares in transferee company account debtor, bank account debtor to transferee company account. Okay, these things, these number of shares and this number, this much amount of cash we have to receive. We have to receive. They didn't receive that. We have to receive. Next. For payment of, for sale of assets not taken over by the transferee company. Okay, you have to sell the assets, whatever it may be, the purchasing company or the transferee company, when they are not taking, compulsory you have to realize the assets in the market and what is the entry for that bank account that are to asset account. Oh, sorry, bank account that are to realization account, not asset account. We are realizing the asset now. So that's why bank account that are to realization account. Next, for payment of liability is not taken over by the transferee company. Liability account that are to bank account. You have to pay off the liability. Next, for realization expenses. For realization expenses. In this case, you have to be very careful. Whether the realization expenses, whether they are borne by the transfer company or the transferee company. When transfer company, when it is paying the realization expenses, okay, realization account that are to bank account, that is the entry. When transfer company, when it pays the realization expenses, sometimes transferee company only it will pay the realization expenses. It will borne the realization expenses. In that, there are two cases. First one is no entry in the books of transfer company. There is no, you should not write any entry. That's why no entry. And when you go for the second case, okay, when you go for second case, so first thing is, transferee company account that are to bank account. Transferee company account that are to bank account for payment of realization expenses. Again, these realization expenses which are borne by the transferee company, they must be reimbursed. So bank account that are to transferee company account. Like this, you'll come across two entries in the second case. In the first case, there is no necessity for you to pass any journal entry. Next, for transfer of preference shares to preference shareholders account. Okay, so sometimes you'll come across preference shares and these preference shares you have to transfer to preference shareholders. Okay, preference share capital account that are to preference shareholders account. This is the journal entry that you have to pass. Next, when you come across the dividends, arrears of dividends, okay, then we have to see whether it is showing more amount or less amount. If preference shareholders are to be paid any excess amount, such as arrears of dividend, then realization account should be debited and preference shareholders should be created. The entry is realization account that are to preference shareholders account. Next, if they are paid less amount, if the preference shareholders are paid less amount, then the above entry will be reversed. That is, preference shareholders account at auto realization account. This is the thing that you have to keep in your mind when you come across preference shares. Okay, whether we are paying any excess amount in the form of arrears of dividend or not, we have to see. Suppose if there are no arrears of dividend, then there is no necessity for you to pass these entries. If there are any arrears of dividend and you have to see whether we are paying any excess amount, then realization account should be debited and preference shareholders account should be created. Otherwise, reverse the case. Okay, preference shareholders account should be debited and realization account should be credited. Next, for transfer of equity, share capital and accumulated profits to equity shareholders account. Equity share capital account that are reserves account that are individually, whatever it may be, the reserves. Okay, profit and loss account that are to equity shareholders account. This is the entry that we'll come across. Okay, this is the entry that we'll come across. Equity share capital account that are reserves account that are accumulated profit and loss account that are to equity shareholders account. Suppose if you come across any debit balance, that thing also you have to transfer to equity shareholders account. So in that case, what is the general entry? Profit and loss account that are to, equity shareholders account that are not profit and loss, equity shareholders account that are to profit and loss account. That is, the above entry will be reversed. Equity shareholders account that are debtor to accumulated losses account, that is profit and loss account, debit balance, and to fictitious assets account. Okay, there we are not transferring all the fictitious assets. We have to transfer to equity shareholders. Next, for transfer of realization profit to equity shareholders, realization account debtor to equity shareholders account. When you come across any profit amount, that must be transferred to the equity shareholders only of the transfer company. So realization account debtor to equity shareholders account. Suppose if you come across any realization loss, okay, reverse the entry, equity shareholders account debtor to realization account in case of realization loss. Okay, now for payment of preference shareholders, preference shareholders account debtor to shares in transfer company to bank account. Okay, when you are going to pay to preference shareholders, okay, the entry is preference shareholders account debtor to shares in transfer company account to bank account. Whatever it may be, the way that you are paying to the preference shareholders. And ultimately, the last one is for payment of equity shareholders. When you are paying to equity shareholders, equity shareholders account debtor to shares in transfer company account to bank account. Like this, you'll come across. These are the various entries that we will come across when you go for the books of transfer company. Okay, this is the accounting treatment. And one thing I want to tell you here is, okay, here you have to prepare two important accounts. Mind it. Okay, two important accounts. First one is realization account and second one is equity shareholders account. Compulsory you have to pass. Compulsory you have to pass realization account and equity shareholders account. And remaining accounts are nothing but optional accounts. That is, whether you prepare them or not, okay, there won't be any problem. But compulsory you have to prepare these two accounts, that is realization account as well as the profit and loss, equity shareholders account, they must be prepared. Now we are going for the accounting treatment in the books of transfer company. Okay. And these things, here only you'll come across the difference between nature of merger and nature of purchase. And when you go for nature of merger, pooling interest method is followed. Pooling of interest method or pooling interest method is followed. That thing you have to keep in mind. And when you go for nature of purchase, there is no necessity for you to follow this method. Okay, what is that and how we have to prepare the journal entries, we are going to see now. On amalgamation, on clubbing, business purchase account debtor to liquidator of transfer company. That is the first entry. That is, it is nothing but the due entry for purchase consideration. How we are writing due entry in transfer of books, in the same way we have to pass a due entry. That is business purchase account debtor to liquidator of transfer company. Next, after that, for recording the various assets and liabilities, okay, taken over by the transfer company. Sundry assets individually, account debtor to sundry liabilities individually, to reserves, to business purchase, all these things. And here, one thing you have to keep, already I told you in the last class, that is in the previous class, when you come across any difference between the credit totals and the debit totals, between the debit totals and credit totals, that difference you have to pass to one account, that is nothing but general reserve account. Okay, so note, please note down this point and keep that in your memory. The difference between debits totals and credit totals is adjusted in the reserves of the transferee company. Reserves of the transferee company. It means that you'll come across general reserve. Next, for payment, for making payments, liquidator of transfer company account debtor to bank account, to share capital account, to securities premium account like that. Okay, when you come across any premium, when you are paying any premium, that thing also you have to take. So liquidator of transfer company account, debtor to bank account, to share capital account, and to securities premium account. Next, for payment of liability expenses. Okay, sometimes you'll come across expenses for this transfer of liabilities. When you are doing this transfer of liabilities, some expenses you will come across. In that case, goodwill account or general reserve account debtor to bank account. Mind it, in most of the cases, you will come across general reserve only in the books of transferee company. You have to take into account the transferee company general reserve only. So goodwill account debtor or general reserve account debtor to bank account. Next, for amalgamation expenses. When they are taking the businesses automatically, you will come across some expenses. That is the purchasing company. Don't be of that opinion that selling company only it will incur expenses. Sometimes the purchasing company also it has to take into account that some expenses. It has to pay some expenses. So when it is paying some expenses for amalgamation purposes, then general reserve account debtor to bank account. General reserve account debtor to bank account. And here only, the main important thing you will come across. The general reserve to be shown in the balance sheet of the transferee company when amalgamation is in the nature of merger. After amalgamation, you have to show the general reserve in the books of transferee company. Sir, how we'll get this general reserve? Okay, for that, you have to take into account the equity share capital of the transfer company, preference share capital of the transfer company, capital reserve of transfer company, general reserve of transfer company, and profit and loss account of transfer company. All these things you have to add. And from that, you have to deduct the purchase consideration given by the transferee company to the transfer company. Compulsory. Okay. I'm telling this. Don't forget. Okay. 1 to 2 times I'm telling. All the things. That is equity share capital of transfer company, preference share capital of transfer company, general reserve of transfer company, any capital reserve of transfer company, profit and loss account of transfer company. All these things, they must be added. Then you have to deduct the purchase consideration given by the transferee company to the transfer company. Then you have to add general reserve of transferee company to the result after deducting purchase consideration, whatever it may be, the result that we come across. You have to add general reserve of the transferee company. Okay, so after that, you have to deduct the amalgamation expenses, whatever it may be. If you won't come across any amalgamation expenses, there is no necessity for you to deduct. But thing is, you have to add general reserve of the transferee company, that is compulsory. Okay, so then only you will come across the general reserve to be shown in the financial position, that is financial statements. Okay, so this thing, it must be considered. Next, in some cases, okay, some people won't take into account the profit and loss account. They'll take into account equity share capital account, preference share capital account, capital reserve and general reserve only, that they won't consider this profit and loss account. When they are not considering the profit and loss account, whatever it may be, the profit and loss account, okay, and whatever it may be, the profit and loss account of the transferee company, they must be merged and they must be shown in the financial statement. Or you can add to general reserve, anything. This is how you will come across in case of merger. Now we are going for purchase method. Okay, when you go for the purchase method, we will come across some features, some characteristic features. What are they? The assets and liabilities of the transfer company should be incorporated at their existing carrying amounts, or alternatively, the consideration should be allocated to individual identifiable assets and liabilities on the basis of their fair values at the date of amalgamation. That is, suppose in the problem, if you are given some assets and liabilities values which vary with the book values, those assets and liabilities which are given, those assets and liabilities values only you have to take into account. Otherwise, if they are not given, you have to take into account the book values of the assets and liabilities, okay, at the time of amalgamation in the books of transferee company. Okay, the next one is the reserves, whether capital reserve or revenue reserve, whatever it may be, on revaluation of the transferor company, okay, other than statutory reserve, should not be included in the financial statements of the transferee company. When you come across revenue reserve or capital reserve, these things you should not include apart from statutory reserve. Statutory reserve, it should be included. Mind it, statutory reserve, it should be included. But revenue reserve or capital reserve, whatever it may be, they should not be included in the financial statements of the transferee company. And anything in excess of the assets and liabilities, that thing I told you already. In purchase method, when you are transferring all the assets and liabilities, you have to be very careful. Here only the main concept will come. When the credit totals, when they are more than debit totals, the difference must be transferred to goodwill account. When debit totals are more than credit totals, the difference must be transferred to capital reserve. These are the various characteristic features that we come across when we are going for transferee company. Okay, now when you come across statutory reserves, okay, when you come across statutory reserves, sir, you told that we should not take into account the revenue reserve or capital reserve. Suppose if we come across statutory reserve, then that statutory reserve you have to take into account. And what is the entry for that? Amalgamation adjustment account debtor to statutory reserve account. Whatever it may be, the statutory reserve that you come across, you have to show separately. And what is entry? Amalgamation adjustment account debtor to statutory reserve account. Okay. And this amalgamation adjustment account, where we have to show? We have to show that on the asset side with the name miscellaneous expenditure in the balance sheet. Miscellaneous expenditure. Okay. In that way, you have to show that. Now, what are the journal entries that we come across? Okay, first one is same business purchase account at or to liquidator of transferor company. That is the first entry. The second entry is various assets account debtor, their book values or fair values to various liabilities account to business purchase account. Okay, here only you'll come across the goodwill amount or the capital reserve amount. Mind it, if credit, once again I'm telling you, if credit totals are more than debit totals, the difference must be transferred to goodwill account. If debit totals are more than credit total, the difference must be transferred to capital reserve. Don't forget this. Okay. Now, for the sale of purchase consideration, liquidator of transfer company account debtor to equity share capital account to preferential share capital account to share premium account to bank account. Like this, you will come across. Okay. The for the sale of the purchase consideration. Next, if any liability is discharged by the transferee company, liability account debtor to share capital account to debentures account to bank account. If any liability, whatever it may be, the liability that was taken, if the transferee company, if it discharges, then you have to take into account this following entry. That is liability account debtor to share capital account debtor to debentures account debtor to bank account. Next, for liquidation expenses paid by the transferee company, goodwill account debtor to bank account. Okay, goodwill account debtor to bank account. When you want to pass an entry in the books of transferee company for the liquidation expenses, then goodwill account debtor to bank account. Next, when you want to keep the statutory reserve in the books, when the transferee company, when it wants to keep the statutory reserve in the books, okay, the entry is amalgamation adjustment account debtor to statutory reserve account. Okay, sometimes it will keep some reserve as statutory reserve, sometimes it won't. Okay, and 90% of the cases they won't try to keep the statutory reserve, and in 10% only, in rare circumstances only, they want to keep the statutory reserve. So in that case, okay, what is the entry? Amalgamation adjustment account debtor to statutory reserve account. These are the various things that we come across. And after passing the journal entries, we have to prepare the financial statement. That is the financial position statement. That is nothing but the new balance sheet after amalgamation. With this, I'm stopping here. And in the next class, we are going to take into account an important topic. Thank you.